What's happening, Magnus Sites? Finally! That's right. I am with Noelle Couette. And we are going to do a Q&A. And y'all better not be asking us stupid questions. Understand? We have a lady present. Alright, so you can actually go to both channels and check this out. She's going to be doing her own little edit, and I'll be doing me like I normally do. And make sure you check out the rest of her videos when you're on her channel, too.
Thanks, guys.
Okay. Now, see the first question? This is what I'm talking about. See? This type of savages that roam my subscriber base. Question. Have you fucked her yet?
Answer. No.
No. Motherfuckers. Let's see. No statements. Rich and ugly or sexy and poor? Sexy and poor.
Ditto.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Waking up to ugly every morning is going to be a problem.
Slash, like, nice. Where does that come in? Sexy, poor, and mean. Wait, no.
Just a tad. Because I wanted to. Okay, cool. Okay. Okay.
The battle of the sexy lips. We both have big lips.
Let's both give them our kissy face.
I win.
Yeah, of course. You're damn right. 90% being male. Of course we're going to pick you. Damn it. Let's see. Oh, boy. That's a statement, son. Are you smashing? How many white women are you going to fuck before you leave? Jesus Christ, guys.
Tyrone's getting down, guys.
Do you guys want kids within the next 5 to 8 years?
No.
I'm not sure. I'm not sure what I want, but I assume the way my career is going, it probably won't happen. If it does, it'll be the tail end of 8 years if I do have children with anyone. Tyrone, when are you going to bring your black ass to England so we can meet? Clockwork Cyborg. I'll probably be in England in a couple of months, so look for me, Clockwork. And if you behave yourself, I'll do a video with you, you savage. Let's see here. Will you give me a shout out?
Punching guy. Hi.
There you go. She gave you the shout out.
Try to keep the punching to a minimum, though. Don't go to jail.
Is Noelle your bae? Is she? And are you happy that you met Tom Holland? Well, Noelle has a boyfriend.
Yeah, I'm sorry, guys.
Okay. And it's not an open relationship.
And it's not him.
Okay. Yeah. She has a boyfriend. It's not me. But it's not an open relationship. It's not like a cuckold thing where he's like, hey, why don't you come by and do my girlfriend in front of me? None of that either. I know it's crazy LA. You get that out here sometimes.
I guess that's true. Yeah.
No. None of that. Okay. And yes, it was cool to meet Tom Holland. Can you say my name, the both of yous? Truly 8-bit, the one and only. FOJ. Jesus Christ, man.
Truly 8-bit, the one and old Joe.
To Noelle and Tyrone, what group in school did you fit into the most? For example, loners, geeks, preps, gamers, outsiders, and why? Thank you for giving me a legitimate question. You go first. I'm gonna hear this.
I was actually homeschooled, but I did go to like acting classes and stuff like that. But I had periods of time when I was in public school. I was weirdly like teacher's pet. I always was teacher's pet, and usually I hung out with the teacher more than the other students. Or I was like the weird one. I never fit into a group. I was just like the weird girl.
Loner.
But not loner, it's just loner.
You're like a mixer. You were a mix, it sounds like.
Yeah.
I was a mix between geek, gamer. Yeah, more a mix between geek and gamer, because I had my friends. But I was like, I was a geeky kid, so and that's when I played video games the most. That's when I was an absolute expert at everything that I did, so... Yeah.
You don't strike me as a geek at all.
Girl, you...
I was a geek too. I had
Wait till I'm gonna do a video one day, and I'm gonna show a lot of my old pictures, especially in high school. Have you seen my high school pic on Instagram with wearing the box?
No.
I'm gonna have to show her right now. So.
Mini reaction, guys.
Let's see here.
Yeah.
She said, yeah. See that? Yeah, baby. That's me. Rocking the box. Yep.
I'm going to hold that against you.
I can see it now. Yeah. Yep. So, while you were being petted by the teacher, I was going through that. Let's see here. Come on.
Gotta wait for them to load.
Yeah. There we go. Tyrone, out of all the women. I just noticed what he was asking. Out of all the women you had on your channel, you have not slept with which two? What? Oh, which? Out of all the women you've had on your channel that you have not slept with, which do you think would be the best
That's a very funny question.
It actually is. And I'm not sure because some say the quiet ones are the craziest. You know, you never know. So I'm not sure.
I'll say it's not me. Self-deprecating over here.
Watch out for the quiet ones so you guys can, let's see. Could y'all follow me on Twitter? Maybe. Let's see. Football.
I don't know anything about football, sorry.
Yeah, well, I don't really watch football, but yes, I do watch EDP445 because he flips the hell out. I do know him. I'm actually friends with him on Facebook. We don't talk much at all, but I had talked to him when I first met him. Let's see. Do you plan on moving to California? This is an amazing time you have with Real Rejects and everyone else. If so, before you do, collab with me before you move. Haha. Oh, that's Danny. Yeah, I do. I might as well say it now. That's pretty much a done deal, y'all. Think I am Hollywood bound. Yep, so I'm going to be out here with all these wonderful actors and actresses, and everyone's welcomed me with open arms, so I think this is the town for me. How did you get such plump lips?
My mama.
She got it from her mama. You got to show me a picture of your mama.
Oh, yeah.
She like high, but she like a MILF.
I don't
want to
talk about that on camera.
Now I gotta see her mom. I can't wait till she shows me a picture of her mom. What's your mom's name?
Tara. Yeah.
So, like, does she live around here?
No. My mom actually passed away 5 years ago.
Okay.
That's not
good. But we have something in common. We're both Geminis.
Yeah.
Both had to deal with loss of our mothers, you know. Mm-hmm. So, we connect on a level, you know what I mean, that a lot of other people don't because... The Gemini thing.
We get along right away. The second that we found out that we were both Geminis, we were like, wow!
Yeah.
My mind was blown. I was like, this makes so much sense.
Now, when was your birthday?
June 2nd.
Okay, mine's June 14th. Yep. And I got friends that are like on the 14th, on the 15th, on the 13th. Like, they're really close to my date. So, do you like eating ice cream with your chicken? Never tried that before. How about you?
I have like chicken and waffles, and that's pretty good. So I imagine if you put ice cream on that, that would taste fantastic.
Okay. Who will win, Batman or Superman?
I like Batman. That's my favorite.
Batman. I like Superman.
Oh shoot.
You know what I'm wearing? Yeah. I mean, Superman's my favorite. I like both of them. But Superman's my favorite. Okay. Here's one question. Jesus Christ! Here we go. There are 10 fishes in the tank. 5 die, 3 drown, and 2 swim away. How many fishes are left?
10 fishes in the tank. Oh, none. Well, the two swim away. They're still in the tank because they can't. Where can they go?
Exactly.
I was like, wait.
Exactly. There's still five.
There's this.
Well, no, there's still 10. Yeah, there's still 10 because they can't fucking go anywhere.
Oh, right? Well, usually when a fish dies, the other fish will eat it. Sorry.
They're cannibals.
Yeah.
Noelle, who do you think would win in a fight, Tyrone or John Cena?
I don't actually. I've never seen John Cena in person. I'm a very, like, I have to see you in person before I can, like, no qualifications, but judge your fighting ability.
Can I challenge you to a Pokemon battle? No, I don't play Pokemon.
What?
If you had a chance to do a movie role, who would you act as? Favorite superhero or hero, etc. Who would it be? Let you go first.
Oh, I've actually done a couple movies already, but...
Big movie star, yeah.
But as far as, like, dream roles go, I guess, I don't know if you guys have seen the show Tudors, but, like, Anne Boleyn and Tudors would be cool. I like period films. Or like fantasy films, like something like Game of Thrones, where basically it's like nothing like me at all. And I like to play the bad guys. Those are my favorite characters.
Okay. You like to play bad guys.
Yeah, like yeah. If I could be Cruella de Vil, that'd be awesome.
Ah, I can see her doing it too. That's funny because a lot of people think I'd be good for villains too.
I feel like your energy is so like not a villain though.
It's not. But I can shift into that. I remember in this acting contest, I played a villain. I had to pick between like these five things to say, and I picked the villain line. And when I said it, they were like looking at me as I walked off stage, like people were standing up, and I was like, "Wow, it must have really
scared."
Like, people were telling me about it, like after, like, "Yo, you killed that line, man." I was like, "Let's see here, John Cena or Donald Trump."
What's the thing with John Cena, guys?
He's a wrestler that
you hate him. Okay, because yes. I was like, I know who he is, but I was like, why do you like...
John Cena. I'll pick John Cena for president over Donald Trump any day, personally.
Oh, but if it's a fight, though, I don't know. Donald Trump can sometimes just start talking and make you, like, be like, and then, like, punch you when you're not paying
Donald
attention.
Trump will pay somebody to beat John Cena's ass.
Yeah.
Will you be my friend? Well...
Your internet friends.
We haven't met you yet. Yeah, and we're right now we're friends on the internet, just like she said. So, what's the first thing you guys did when you first met up with each other?
Oh, we
talked on Ryan's couch. That was the first time.
Yeah, we met physically, like in person when we met. I'd gone over to Ryan's house and he was there. I don't know. That was like a week ago or something.
Yeah.
And then we tried to go to a restaurant and I accidentally gave him the wrong address. And I was at the other location not knowing there were two. And he's like, I'm at the entrance. And I was like,
Yeah, that was funny. And that day I had been running so much. I was just like, all right, enjoy your dinner. I was so tired that day. But I was like, I cannot believe. I think it was the day I was in the car accident too.
You were in a
car? It was a hit and run. And I wasn't in the car, though, but it totally pissed me off, and I was just like, great.
Yeah. You know, it's funny, because I went home right after that and fell asleep at, like, 9:30 that night.
So, yeah, we both went to bed early that night.
Yeah.
Question. Tyrone, would you do me the honor of being my first YouTube video on my channel I'm working on? I'm not sure what you mean by that. Of being in your first video. Well, it depends on what you write me at my business email. It depends on what you want, but go ahead and send that to my email. Tell me what you want to do. When do you plan on quitting YouTube? No, I'm not a hater. I'm just wondering.
Oh, for me, YouTube right now is just more of like a fun creative release. So it's nothing that I'm necessarily planning on quitting on right now.
Said release.
Creative. I need to figure that one out. But, so there's no plan on quitting it because it still is fulfilling something for me. So.
Cool. Right now I don't plan on quitting it ever. Even if I were to become a big movie star out here, you're still going to get videos from me. And I think that'll make it even cooler. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure if I were to become big, I'd probably have my handlers telling me what I can and can't. You know, well, you know, good publicity, can't say that, you know. Maybe I'll listen to them depending on what it is or not. Because I don't know business as well as they know, you know what I mean? But you're still going to get videos from me no matter what. Yeah, so, let's see here. Would you rather be immortal and live for eternity, but in depression and with a desire to commit suicide, or have everything you ever wanted for a month before dying of illness?
Second one.
Who the fuck wants to live in eternity and you want to kill yourself and you're depressed? The fuck is that shit, man? That's an eternal torture in hell. Otherwise, you get everything fulfilled in your life and you die. That's best.
Yeah.
You get to do everything. You're totally fulfilled and then you go. You know what I mean? What are your thoughts on Disney continuing to put Marvel and Star Wars films for as long as they can? Are there any film storylines you guys would like to see in particular? Now, are you a Marvel or Star Wars fan?
Yes.
Ooh,
I am.
Ooh, I know that.
For me, I don't necessarily like exploiting a story and kind of like taking it just when you're making something just to make money. I'm kind of like, ugh. Like, I like good stories. So as long as a story is done well, regardless of whether it's Marvel or Star Wars or Disney or whatever, if it's a franchise, but it continues to do really well, I'm all about it being made for as long as possible, because why not continually be entertained by something that you enjoy?
Exactly. I feel the same way about it. I really do. She didn't say anything wrong. And there's no particular storylines I want to see, but I do want to see more of Vader. A lot of these in-between stories that we haven't seen, like Vader and his apprentices and stuff like that, that I've heard about. So I would like to see that.
Did you see the Kylo Ren SNL thingy? Did you react to it?
I did. I took it down because like people were getting strikes for it or something like that.
Oh,
yeah.
That
so, but it, yeah. That was hilarious. Who was your favorite YouTuber?
Oh,
yeah, who's your favorite YouTuber?
I have a couple people. I like this girl named Kira Rose. She's pretty great. I like, actually, I'm forgetting her name. She used to be Beauty Crush, but now her name's Sam, but I forgot her last name. But if you look up Beauty Crush, she'll probably pop up. And Tyrone. And myself.
She threw that.
Throwing out some self love there.
Wait, I was gonna say myself. You gotta be your own favorite fan. You got to. That's how you make your channel grow. But other than myself, let's see. I really like the Hodge twins. They crack me the fuck up. They really do. I know when I first started, I really liked Hodge twins, John Marbles. Jeremy Johns. They were like really my favorites to watch. I watched a lot of them. So, Cherry Crush is my other favorite. I'm actually kind of kidding, but the guys that know who she is are going to laugh at that. So, she like does these ASMR, sexual ASMR videos.
What's ASMR?
Like, have you ever seen the videos where people are like, their face is like in the damn camera? Okay, so I'm going to tear apart this paper towel. There are people that like their voice and doing these different sound effects. Like, can you hear the paper towels together? It relaxes them. It gives them chills and tingles. And now some people look at it as erotic, but just look up ASMR. It's hilarious. But it's real deal. Like, people have told me, Tyrone, if you started an ASMR channel, I would totally watch it. I've actually thought about it.
You have a very soothing voice. Yeah, I like your voice.
They tell me it's like velvet.
You don't need to do anything creepy, though. just start reading. Just start reading audiobooks. Like, make an audiobook channel or something.
You know what, guys? I think I may just start a separate ASMR channel. And we'll see how it goes. let's see here. Do you like The Walking Dead?
I only saw the pilot. The pilot was great, though.
I did, too. That's what set me off, and I watched everything through. Favorite show?
Breaking Bad. Or, Peaky Blinders.
All right. Mine right now is Walking Dead. So, what is your goal on YouTube?
Yours is to hit 1,000,000 subscribers. Right.
Everyone knows my goal.
I think, I don't know. I'm not really doing it for like financial reasons or anybody else. It's simply like just to make things that make me happy and share them with people. I don't know. Very simple, boring goal.
Okay. She's more of a hippie about hers, you know? It's like, yes. Just want love. And,
just want to love, you know, and spread energy, the love.
Dude, man.
Vibes, yo.
Yeah. Have you held the Dark Million Mjolnir yet?
He wishes.
I think she'd wish to witness the power, but we'll leave it at that. Who is your favorite Walking Dead character?
Well, I don't have one because I don't watch the show.
Oh, you don't watch it?
Mm-mm.
Did you have one watching the pilot?
Okay.
Rick, of course. Of course it's Rick. God damn it. That's the dad. That kind of takes over. To Noelle and Tyrone, what group did you fit into school the most? Yes.
I think we already...
Yeah, we already did that one. Hmm.
Thanks for asking again, though. He's like really, really wanting us to answer it.
Oh, great. I don't know if you know about this right now. With all the fiasco involving you and the Fine Bros, Grade A, and even the other reactors as well, I came up with a new idea. How about whenever you guys do... Okay, that's not a question. Okay, let's see. Dear Mr. Magnus, if you were trapped on a desert island with John Cena... Oh, God. What would you do? Would you kill him, use his body as a raft? Or would you work together to build a new perfect island community? I'd be working with them to get the fuck off the island. That's what I'd be working to do. How is the West Coast compared to the East Coast? It's different. I gotta say, it's very different in certain ways. The drivers are fucking nuts over here. You guys don't let anybody over.
No, the driving here is crazy.
Yes. Let's see. Tyrone and Noel, how do you feel the upbringing on different coasts affect lifestyles? Because she's from Texas.
Yeah, I was like, I didn't grow up on either coast, so.
Yeah, she grew up in like,
well, no.
Middle at the bottom.
Yeah. How did you grow up on?
Yeah, East Coast. I don't know about upbringing, you know what I mean? But I don't know. People are just different here, you know? I'm getting used to it. I can't really put it into too many words right now. Because I'm still
absorbing it.
Yes. Are y'all fucking? No. You going to move to California, most likely. Do you think you could start a workout series for beginners who want to build their body? Like showing us some good routines? Well, I've already got a lot of videos on there. So you can check those out in my playlist. What's your favorite book?
My favorite book is The Alchemist.
Okay, I've heard of that. I've actually got it on audio.
I was like, have you not read it?
Yeah, I haven't read it yet.
You have to.
I mean, I haven't listened to it.
You have to. Listen to it on the way back to New York.
That's what I was thinking.
It's so good. It's life-changing. I've read it. I read it probably like every 3 years or so.
Wow.
It's like a really good book.
So you're an avid reader?
Yeah. I'm reading 2 books right now. So
they say some of the most successful people in the world are avid.
Because you soak in things and learn.
I get sleepy reading, and other people have told me that happens to them.
Yeah.
So I like audio a lot because I can just go and listen and do whatever I want while, you know, listening to it. You ever plan on updating your setup? For example, getting a better camera, PC. I've got a fucking $1,000 4K camera. Kiss my ass. Okay. So the camera ain't getting replaced for years, okay? And the PC is still gonna stay the same for a while too. I've got like a $2,000 fucking PC and a $1,000 camera, and you're like, updating. You're probably talking about is the lighting. You get the real lighting in my house, so if you think it's bad, too bad. I'm very frank on my channel, if you don't know.
No, I get it. Well, because some people are expecting you to go out and get like oh, a light just went out. Like, yeah. Fancy Canon, got blah, a weird blah, lighting blah, setup and lenses there. And stuff, but it's like, for what you do on your channel, you don't need to, like, have all that.
Exactly.
It's unnecessary.
Very. Do I prefer Noelle or Miss Jackson? They both have their great qualities.
She's like right now Noelle, she's sitting next to me.
I haven't worked with Noelle enough to prefer her over Miss Jackson, but they both have their good qualities, I can tell. So I would have to work with Noelle first before making a decision on who I prefer.
I don't know who Miss Jackson is, but that sounds nice.
She's a character. Just go through my videos, you'll find her.
Someone's mad at me for not making videos, sorry.
What happened? Someone's mad at you, say?
He says, do a reaction for her channel so we can see some damn content. Yeah, no, I just filmed something that, it's my Wi-Fi, guys, it's my Wi-Fi, I'm trying. But I filmed something, I need to edit it and post it up, and that has a brief explanation of why I have not uploaded anything for 2 months.
Yeah, her Wi-Fi is the antichrist of Wi-Fi.
I honestly shouldn't even count as Wi-Fi. It blows my mind that I'm paying for this.
Because I have 75 and 75 in my house.
Yeah, I've got 3 megabits per second of downloading speed and 1 megabit per second of uploading speed, which basically
horrible.
Means that it doesn't happen.
Who would do that to a person?
No, I cried. It was pretty bad. That's like the best Wi-Fi I can get. I tried everything.
I actually have Wi-Fi with my phone that I didn't know that I had. I have hotspot Wi-Fi.
Oh, do you have unlimited data though?
Unlimited data, okay. But only 5 gigabytes per month of Wi-Fi. I've used it while I'm out here because I've been having issues with my setup here. Let's see, if I was a wrestler in WWE, what would the name be and who would I feud with besides John Cena? My name would be Tyrone Magnus, and I would feud with The Rock. That would be a dream for me.
I love Dwayne Johnson.
let's see. Yeah, you should fucking put in. What would I do if there wasn't any YouTube? I'd still be pursuing acting and modeling and voiceovers. So, yeah. What about you?
I actually don't know, because I've spent a good lot of my time watching YouTube videos. I probably would have just ended up reading more at that point. Because at the moment, like, my content, I'm not creating as much content as I'd like. But as far, I'm definitely more on the consumer side of a YouTuber. So I'd probably have a lot more time. But I'd probably be consuming something else, realistically.
All right. What's your favorite thing to do on your free time?
I love tea. I don't know, I like to drink tea and take bubble baths, and I like watching movies.
Calm down, fellas.
I don't know. No, that's literally, like, I'll just put up my laptop there, watch a movie, drink some tea, sit in the bubble bath, and like 3 hours go by, I'm like, oh, my feet are all wrinkly. That's probably my favorite thing to do. Another light went out day.
I have this setup in here. When I first came to this guest house, there were only 2 light bulbs, and they were those fluorescent, spirally-looking ones.
No.
Okay. It wasn't enough light in here. I went out to the store, bought 4 60-watt bulbs, put them in, and they, when they get too hot, they go out. Mm-hmm. And then they come back on. None of them were blowing out. They'll be back on, trust me. First time I thought the house was haunted. Let's see here. Would you like to visit Mexico?
I've been to Mexico once, and I'm actually, sorry, my mouth's full. I'm thinking of taking a cruise within the next couple months.
Okay.
That involves Mexico.
Cool.
So, yes.
Cool. Shit. I might have to go on that cruise. Let me know about it. For real, because I've never been. Favorite thing to do in your free time? And yes, I would like to visit Mexico.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Favorite thing to do in my free time? Probably work out. When I have a chance to work out, that's probably my favorite time.
You need to rub off on me.
So you can work out. We'll do a workout video together.
Yeah. Yes, and then you'll just see me be like.
Yeah, I say work out. How about you? Oh, so you said bubble baths.
Yeah,
bubble
baths.
Right?
Yeah. Doing absolutely nothing after. Mine's like the opposite of yours. Chilling.
What are you more excited about, Batman v Superman, or Deadpool, or Captain America Civil War?
Honestly, I'm digging Deadpool right now. No one else is probably going to say that.
Yo, yeah. I can't lie. Like, I'm so curious about Deadpool.
Yeah.
You know, I still have to say Batman v Superman, but they're all really close. Like, Batman v Superman, then it's Captain America Civil War, then it's Deadpool.
Oh, mine's the opposite. Like, because...
It's Deadpool, and then...
And Civil War, and then...
And Batman v Superman. I've got to see my boy Supes do his thing, you know. So, have I finally got to experience Noelle's new enthusiasm? No!
Enthusiasm? What does that
They're
even...
They're talking about your badge. No.
But, like, what does that have to do with
that has
the
to
Netherlands?
Do with, the Netherlands. when I first had a female YouTuber on, I did a video telling who it was going to be, and that I really liked her energy and everything. I don't ever remember saying enthusiasm.
Oh, but it became like a slang term.
Yeah, he roasted me. He said, Tyrone said it was her enthusiasm that, you know, made him want to work with her. So that's been an ongoing joke forever. He said, I have two. Don't worry, they're not sexual. Cool. If you were running for office, what would your campaign slogan be?
Oh, I take way too long to make decisions like this.
Yeah, like...
I don't know.
That's a question, like, what?
That I would have to come back to you on that one.
And two, if given the chance, which person would you like to be for a day? Or who would you like to exchange roles with?
Okay, so I know this sounds like a little weird, but I'd like to fly other light. I'd like to swap places with my future self, because I feel like...
Ooh, she went deep with that, didn't she?
No, that's just the truth, because it's
that's
like...
different, though.
You know, then I'd realize all the things that I'm worrying about are putting value in now that don't necessarily need my attention, and be able to come back and probably be a lot less stressed out.
She made me think about this question on a deeper level, because I was just going to like name an actor or something like that. I would like to switch places with my past self. Yes.
Ah!
So I can right all the wrongs I got up here. You know, life is about learning and you make mistakes for a reason, but I'm going to go back and handle some shit and change some stuff that I should have did differently. So, yeah, like that. Look at this shit. Which way does your dick lean? No homo. God damn. What's Noelle's favorite position? Jesus Christ, guys. Would you have rather have sex with a goat and have nobody know it, or not have sex with a goat but everybody thinks you did?
I think I would want people to think I had sex with a goat, because then they'd be like, please explain to me how I did it. Like, all the stories that would come my way would be so interesting.
I'm not having sex with a fucking goat. So everybody can think that I fucking did. Look at this. Noelle, Miss Jackson, or Mamba Jumbo?
I guess Jeez. This Miss Jackson person is like, because I've heard of Mamba Jumbo, but.
She's really? Relatively new. She's literally an ex-girlfriend from years ago.
But if y'all don't have beef, then that's fine.
No, we don't. Okay. We don't. She comes on my channel, she actually, from time to time. How old are you?
I'm 21.
38.
What?
It's nuts, right? I don't even believe it.
I don't even believe it. I gotta see some
I don't believe it. I don't believe it. Yeah, so. Let's see. Am I gonna come down to Dallas, Texas for any conventions? I don't know.
Are there conventions
there? I don't know. What type of conventions?
Yeah.
Porn conventions? Like, what do you mean? I'll probably bring Ryan so he can bug the hell out. Make all the dick jokes he wants. I'm sure he'll clean up over there. But I do. I would like to plan on visiting Texas. I think that'd be cool.
Go to Austin.
Austin's cool. Like Stone Cold Steve Austin. Cool. I will. Hulk or Vegeta.
I don't know who the second one is.
You don't know the second one is?
No.
You don't watch Dragon Ball Z, do you?
No.
No. Okay. I think I'm going to do this with my second guest also, because she watches Dragon Ball Z. And, yeah, that would be cool. Let's see here. Oh, as far as it goes for me, I probably like Vegeta a little more than Hulk.
I did not know there was a live-action Teen Titans movie coming out. Yes, I would love to go see that. That's awesome.
Hell yeah. Hell yeah, I'm going to see it. Am I interested in doing vlogs? Not really, but from time to time, y'all get little things from me. How about you? Any other question was for me?
I actually do some vlogs. Like, I would say half of my channel is vlogs, but it's more like, that's kind of the thing, is that I'm usually talking about something that's on my mind, and I just make a video about it. Or I love food, and so I like make a video about it.
I saw you going to like Wegmans or something, didn't I? Was that one of your vlogs?
What is it?
Where are you going?
Oh, Costco.
Costco.
Yeah, and then I went there when it was closed. Yeah. And I was like,
that was funny.
I was so mad too, because I was like planning this whole thing. I was like, I'm going to Costco, I'm going to vlog. Da, da, da. I got there and it was closed. And I was like, no.
I thought that was funny. I was laughing my ass off when I saw that. Do you think Deadpool will be a success?
I think the advertising is intriguing. So if that's any sign of anything, I think people will go.
Isn't some of the best advertising you've ever seen for a damn movie? I think it probably is the best advertising I've ever seen for any one movie. Just to create.
It just makes me
want to
go.
Yes.
Yeah.
To both of you, if you could have any three superpowers, what would they be? Mine would be the ability to control the destiny of matter, telepathy, and the ability to control cytolysis, whatever the fuck that is. But should I go first?
Yeah,
go first.
Sure. I'm going to answer first all the time on this.
Let's see here. Teleportation, invulnerability. Teleportation, invulnerability, and the ability to read minds. I'd be unstoppable in that form.
Yeah. I've always said shape-shifting as like...
Oh, that's scary.
When anyone tells me what superpower I want, that's shape-shifting. So I guess why I have two other ones.
I could see her like going to her favorite celebrity crush's house and like... morphing into his girlfriend.
But shape shifting would be number one. Ability to like manipulate time, and having a optional perfect memory. Like if I want to remember something.
Talking about memory.
Yeah.
Most memories flawed.
Yeah, like I wouldn't want to like constantly remember everything, because I think that would just be such a burden. But like if I wanted to remember something.
You could totally recall.
Basically, like, have, like, a camera in my head.
Okay, so you want to be able to have total recall.
Yeah.
There's a question for Tyrone. What or who got you into making YouTube channels and into the channel? And what made you start doing reactions after doing so many other styled videos? I still remember those hilarious videos that you made 2 or 3 years ago ranting about Cena. You guys are what got me into reacting. I was doing wrestling stuff. You guys started writing me and said, asking me to react. When you weren't saying reacting, you were just saying, I want to know what you think of this video. So that's how it started. And I got into YouTube through wanting a side door into Hollywood, kind of like creating a fan base, and getting known, and then being approached, which is what's happening. So
yeah. And that's how it's working now for anybody that's trying to be an actor or anything. Try to use social media to your advantage, because it can help you out a lot, actually.
Yeah, I'm hearing like you guys have to have that now. It's like,
yeah, it's funny because I don't have like a huge following, and I've been told before that I don't have enough followers. And I'm like, what?
So make sure y'all go over there and subscribe to Noelle.
Oh, thanks.
Even if you just like her for her lips, do it. okay.
There were other coolies, I swear.
But they're guys, you know, we're superficial at first.
And then right. You get to know me and you're like, oh, unsubscribe.
This crazy chick, man. I think Tyrone only introduces us to girls he wants to smash because he knows how the questions will be. And he can blame us.
That's actually really funny, but so not true. It was actually my idea to do a Q&A.
Yeah, so now. fucking guys. Do you plan on changing your catchphrase after 1 million? Yeah, I do.
No, he's just going to
I do. Because I'm not sure. I'm not sure yet. I've said 10 million after that because that's the next goal. Like, after you get 10 million subscribers, you get that diamond. Like, have you seen that?
No.
Yeah, just like this diamond, like, you know, looking play button. You have to see it.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
That's crazy.
For Daredevil season 2, are you Team Daredevil or Team Punisher?
I actually haven't seen Daredevil, but I'm stoked. Because that's on Netflix, right? It's on Netflix, right? Like, it's a Netflix produced show?
It is Netflix, yes.
I'm like, I'm stoked with all this Netflix stuff because I don't have cable, so. I don't really have Netflix either. I just kind of bum Netflix. So, Netflix is free. Cable is like $200 a month out here in LA.
$200 a month?
It's so expensive because they know, like, you people love watching movies. You guys like watching yourselves on TV. We're going to make it expensive.
Wow.
Yeah, okay. So I don't have cable.
So hold on.
I wish I did, because like right now I have a movie playing on cable, but I can't watch it because I don't have cable.
So. Will you be streaming the new Doom game? No. How come I haven't asked any of these girls out?
Yeah.
Because they're my Kylie. She's like, yeah.
No, I'm serious. Like, if you like a girl, like, why does it matter if you guys both do you work together?
Oh no. Well. They're my colleagues, and I like to watch women before I ask them out.
That makes sense.
I'm observant.
And, he's creep.
No. I don't stalk people.
No, I know what you mean. Yeah, no, you're not a, like, oh, she's pretty, let me ask her out. You're a, like, let me see your character before I, like, invest my time in
right,
you.
Right, exactly. Because I don't like to waste my time. I really don't. Mama Jumbo actually figured that out. She said that in a Q&A that me and her did, and they were like... She was like, you know what? He's very observant. He's not like what you think he is. And I was like, she's right. Can you guys try to do your best impression of each other? Well, can you please do Tyrone's makeup? She's not putting makeup on me.
I don't have any. I have lipstick. Do you guys
She's... Hell no.
I have a couple lipsticks.
I am all man. Okay?
If
you want to do an impression
I'm
on me.
Really bad at impressions, like, so bad. I did, like, that was the whole reason why, like, it wasn't beef, but, like, we got, I guess, associated with each other on the internet was because I was copying you. You do this, like, thing, and I sat there doing that, and that caused, like, a lot of people were like, why is she making fun of Tyrone? And caused all this drama. I really can't do it.
You can't do an impression?
No.
Okay, I'm going to do an impression of Noel.
I am Noel, correct?
I don't think I'm like that.
My tongue.
I do a long time.
Follow me. Watch me on Ryan Ranch too. And bring me coffee.
Yeah, that's good.
I'm sorry, that's like Noel's like alter ego.
Yes, like if I were actually attractive.
She doesn't think she's attractive. Guys, let her know.
There's a joke.
Noelle is attractive. We have to bring her spirits up. Damn Hollywood actresses and their insecurities.
Honestly, though, they can get crazy out here. They tell me that I'm not skinny enough. I'm like, what?
They told you?
Mm-hmm.
You don't understand how small she is. When I saw her in person, I was like, holy shit, she's smaller than
that
I
was, like,
thought.
One of the first things he said. He, like, I was expecting him to be a lot louder. And I think he was expecting me to be a lot louder. So when we met each other, we were both kind of, like, more quiet.
Yeah.
I was sitting there at one point, he's like, I didn't realize how small you were. I was like,
It's like all I can put in my pocket.
Yeah.
Let's go for a ride. Come on. Here you go.
I could probably, just like this.
Serious question. What is the best way to approach girls if you are shy? Okay. Now we're getting into some shit where this is, you know, okay. What's the best way to approach girls if you are shy? I know the whole idea is to be confident, and I did approach some girls and tell them they were beautiful, but I really don't know what to say, and I'm 18, by the way. I'll let you handle this.
Well, I think you started off really well by saying that you found the girl beautiful. As long as you're, I think the main points are to be respectful when you're asking somebody else of your, asking somebody out of yourself and of that other person. So if you just note that you find them attractive and that you're interested in their number or you want to go out with them, then that's fine. And I think something to tell yourself if you're shy is the, like, worst case scenario. Like, what were you doing 5 minutes ago? Like, you weren't with that girl anyway. So there really is nothing to lose if you just remind yourself that it's like, one thing. I'm also reading this book called Girl Boss right now. And one of the things she says a couple times is you don't get what you don't ask for. So I just say just go for it and own it. And if you need to give yourself a little pep talk beforehand, no one's judging you.
That's true. And yeah, she didn't say anything wrong. I totally agree with everything she said. I don't think I would be adding anything to it.
You said she didn't say anything wrong twice. Yeah. Now, like, are you expecting me to be like,
bleh. Well, or anything that I disagree with or have a different take on. Put it that way.
I was like, interesting wording, Tyrone.
Sorry, to, you know. And I think it's best coming from a woman also because she knows what girls want and how they want to be approached for the most part. So, what would I do if I found out Noelle was the founder of C Nation? I just slipped something in her tea.
What is C Nation?
John Cena's fan club, basically. Oh. All right, so you sound like you were going to add something else.
Oh, I was like, if you do ask a girl out and she does say no, I will say another worst case scenario is that you totally made her day. So there's that. Like, if the best you can do is just make a girl smile, then just do that.
Okay. Sounds different. Best moment you had with your mother. That's going to be hard for both of us.
Yeah. We did spend, because we lived like an hour outside of Austin and about 3 hours away from Dallas, and I grew up acting and that's where auditions were. So we'd spend a lot of time in the car. And we'd, like, she loves show tunes, which now I'm not, like, the biggest fan of, but we would, like, blast show tunes and sing to them. We talked about, like, we were talking about boys all the time. Like, she's a pretty open mom. So, honestly, probably, like, the car rides.
But, yeah, I did, you know, so I was going to say, like, I used to go places with her. Like, she would always jump to go places with me, whether it was shopping somewhere or stuff like that. So, I enjoyed my talks with my mom. I enjoy talks, not just, hey, mom, so no. I enjoy talks with her, so.
Yeah.
Have you ever been to the UK?
Yes.
I haven't. Ooh, cool. Where'd you go?
I think I've been once. I might have gone twice. I can't remember now. But I actually have family over there, so I just went to go visit them. I think once. I was 12. I might have gone when I was 7. I can't remember.
So what are you?
British, Polish, German, Spanish, French.
Oh, that's a lot. That's a lot of white folks.
All the white stuff is right in here.
She is pure Aryan blood.
Yeah.
Blonde hair, blue eyes. Come on in, sister. And don't make no more videos for that Negro right there. Oh, it's the one if I made her uncomfortable with that.
No. Times have changed. And that's like what makes me happy is that most
You're
people
from Texas.
Aren't. Well, some people in Texas are still, but most people, you know, realize that like the color of your skin doesn't affect like who you are as a person as far as like your morality and your qualities and all that good stuff that makes you cool.
That's good. Do you have any siblings?
I do. I have a little sister.
Okay. They're asking me, what is my brother like? He's the total opposite of me.
I want to see
Except this. He looks like me. Okay? He's the total opposite of me.
Mm-hmm. How old is he?
34.
Okay.
Just keep that in mind. Let that marinate. Okay, next.
Skittles or M&M's? Peanut butter M&M's. Or not peanut M&M's, not peanut butter.
She skipped down questions.
Well, because some of them were like dirty. I was like, ugh, not answering that on the camera.
Yes, very, very, you guys, I tell you, man. That's funny because I didn't say it and I noticed that she skipped past your vulgarity, Dan. You hooligans.
Yes.
Skittles or M&M's? M&M's.
Ah, yeah.
M&M's. There we go. Let's see. Have you ever gotten into a fist fight?
Noelle
was a bully.
Not without trying, but technically no, I've not been in a fist fight, but I've attempted to start one.
Really?
I am so small that like people just came up and grabbed me and I was that girl that was like floating in.
So at least she tried.
I tried.
Yes. And I have. Last fight I was in, though, I was in like elementary school. Like I never really got in the fights.
The last fight.
Yeah. I never got in the fights. I wasn't that guy. Do you like each other? Of course I like
each other. I think I'd be hanging out with him if I didn't like him.
You know? Let's see here. Which movie are you most excited about this year? Batman v Superman, period. Sorry, I've waited long enough.
Suicide Squad sounds pretty dope. I'm very interested to see like what they do with that. And then Hail Caesar comes out next week and I'm excited about that one.
Okay. This guy asked me which superhero I would like to be. He gave me like Hulk, Captain America, Batman, Superman, Thor, Spider-Man. Anyone that follows me knows who I would pick. There's no need for me to answer that question. So answer it for him, Magnus Sykes. Smash or pass. Jesus Christ. You give me a shout out. Nan's original. There you go. You got it. Really been into white girls lately. And Noelle's one of the reasons why. I guess that's a statement. Because he sent like a loving face. So he loves you.
Oh, yeah. But the face is like.
Like, it's like all
it's like in the middle
hearts.
Of blowing
it's
a kiss.
Hearts,
well,
yes.
Yeah.
So Garrett loves you.
Thanks, Garrett. I love you, too.
Are you going to move to L.A.? Yes. Tyrone
is king. That
yes.
was great.
Oh, what kind of food are you good at making and why?
Oh, okay. This is actually, I don't know, maybe this could potentially get a lot of hate comments, but I genuinely find so much joy in making sandwiches. No, I don't think that my place as a woman is in the kitchen unless I want to be there, but I actually love making sandwiches. Like, it's kind of weird. Like, it makes me so happy.
So she can make a mean sandwich.
I make really good sandwiches.
Okay.
And then I also do, like, normal cooking stuff. Like, I don't know. I just kind of, I've only messed up one recipe. Everything else, I'm just like, I feel like cooking this type of blah, 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 and I just make it.
Well, what I'm good at, I've been told my chicken soup is really good. This is gonna sound stereotypical, but my mom was really good at frying chicken. She was Southern. Everyone loved her chicken, and she gave me her recipe before she passed. And I know how to make her chicken now, but I know how to make it also in an organic way with organic chicken and buckwheat flour and all that stuff.
Well,
I gotta make
you
it like
coming
that,
over
so.
To my house when you move out here, make me some chicken. I do also make really good guacamole. Like,
oh, okay.
Like real good.
Alright.
He has my number, guys.
digits.
he got him.
Sidekick.
No,
side
chick.
I gave these. Noelle, how does it feel sitting next to Tyrone Magnus? I heard he's a guy has a godly presence, being close to Tyrone Magnus. And when are you coming back to the Real Rejects?
Ryan and I were just talking about some video ideas, so I'm not sure, but hopefully soon. And then as far as like sitting next to Tyrone Magnus, I guess like I wouldn't. Sometimes people would use the word godly in like an intimidating way. I don't think that Tyrone's intimidating because you're just like one of those people that I feel like people feel comfortable with. Like, okay. Like I feel like
I get that a lot.
You know, like if you are a religious person, God's that person that you talk to about everything, knows everything. So like maybe like godly way of like you're unfiltered around you. Like I don't feel like I have to be some certain way.
Send your donations to the Church of Magnus. Oh, I'll post the link below.
You're gonna get like thrown in a mental ward for starting a cult.
Who would I kill, kiss, or marry? Ariana Grande, Selena Gomez. I'm trying to figure out who these girls are. It was Demi Lovato.
I know them. So I would kill Ariana Grande, kiss Selena Gomez, kiss Demi Lovato, and then marry Selena Gomez.
I'm mixing up Ariana Grande and Selena Gomez. I'm like thinking they're like the same person. But Selena Gomez is doing the Bieber.
Yeah.
Ray. God damn it.
He's good.
Yeah. Ariana Grande.
According to Wikipedia, Ariana Grande Butera.
She looks like Selena Gomez.
Ariana Grande is an American.
Selena Gomez.
Selena Gomez is way hotter.
Nah, I don't think she's a way hotter. They're both good looking. What was the other one? Demi Lovato.
According to Wikipedia, Demetria Devon Lovato is an American singer, songwriter, actress, and model.
I don't know, man. I need time to think. I could do all three, though.
He's like, he's going to kiss,
they're all good looking.
Marry, and kill all of them.
Fuck, and I thought I was going to keep my place.
Mm.
20 years, what do you want to be known for? Playing an iconic superhero.
Really?
Yes, I'm going to be the Black Superman. Yes. And done it well.
Oh.
I want to have played an iconic role, period. Whether it's a superhero or not, that's what I'm going to be known for. An iconic role that's just stitched into the fabric of pop culture. I want to be a quotable character, like all that stuff.
Mm-hmm. Like household name, kind of jazz.
Yep.
I do love to act and all that stuff, but ultimately, like, it's one of those things. You have to have money to be a philanthropist, and you have to be able to say the word. But I just really have, like, a strong pull toward, like, there's this campaign called Because I Am a Girl, and I just signed up to sponsor a girl over there, which I'm excited about because I've been wanting to do it for a while. But helping with like that kind of stuff is ultimately like what I'd like to be known for. I mean, it'd be cool if I'm like, you know, that girl that had two lines in that movie, but she's also like over in Kenya doing this and that, helping little kids. Like, I think that'd be so cool. Like, jam with little kids, helping kids get better education and food.
Cool. If you were sentenced to death, what would be your last meal?
There's this restaurant called Providence out here in LA, and I actually cried at dinner because it was that good. I'm not kidding.
She was telling me she gets emotional and stuff. She was like, she hears somebody die and be like, oh wow, that's sad. But then
food. I'm
my Wi-Fi sucks.
My scale of emotions isn't like normal person's, but I think I would eat it. I have like an 19 course meal there.
Holy shit,
I was really
extravagant.
I'm serious. And it was like, I actually cried. I'm really like not ashamed. I was like, this is the most beautiful food experience I've ever had.
Holy crap. I'm gonna have to go there and see if I cry.
I'm down to come with you. It's like so good.
Where is it at?
It's on Melrose out here in LA.
Okay. Who's your favorite actor?
Tom Hardy.
Yes. Yes. I forgot.
I just didn't know I said that.
I can't believe I forgot.
I forgot too. You can tell by my reaction. I practically like jumped off the couch.
Oh, I'm going to milk this.
No.
I totally forgot. Oh boy. So,
if you watch my reaction to like, there on my channel, there's a reaction to one of his videos, and like everyone's comments are blowing up, like, look at her face. face when he does the Bane voice.
Let me tell you this. I thought she was unique. There are two other girls that love the Bane voice.
Oh, okay, yes, good. So I'm not alone. Like, I've never met a girl that's like...
So it was me, well. It was Miss Jackson and Mama Jumbo. They all love my voice. It makes them horny. So since she has a boyfriend, I'll leave that alone. Because she's not tempted to do anything. Yeah. Wouldn't want him to kill me.
You haven't met him yet, actually.
No, I haven't.
No, he's out of town right now. No, shit, I don't
know. He's out of town. Woo! I'm just kidding, man. Just kidding. Nah. Okay. Don't come down here and kill me in the guest house, and I'm just dead for the maid to find me tomorrow. And what they asked me who my four favorite sports player is. When I was growing up, it was Michael Jordan. Everybody was into Michael Jordan back then. You know what I mean? He's the only person that really made me watch basketball. But that's about it. It's weird because like new questions are showing up in the middle of the ones that we already saw.
Yeah, because that one's like 5 minutes ago.
Yeah, it's weird. Hold on, y'all. Shit, have patience.
I feel like we've read these ones. Yeah.
Okay, I think that's where I left off. No, well, okay.
Yeah, we did that one.
Feeling sitting next to me. Best black superhero: Blade, Black Panther, Falcon, Luke Cage, Storm, Cyborg, or Static Shock. Right now, for me, it's Blade. I'm looking to see what this Black Panther does, though, in Civil War, because he could end up being my favorite.
I used to love the Blade movies.
Obsessed with them.
I used to be upset with them. I just cried about the Blade movies too while eating in Providence.
let's see. What happened between Ryan and Sally? Who the hell is Sally?
She's a girl that they used to do videos with. I don't know.
Is that the one with the red hair?
Yeah. I have no idea. Plus, I'm like not.
You'll have to ask Ryan about that.
Ask them.
Were you ever married?
No.
I felt like I was, though. You remember I was in a relationship for almost 8 years. And I remember people told me after I split, they were like, wow, man, don't think about it as being bad. Like, you were married longer than most people. You know, and I was like, wow, well. I mean, they said you were together longer than most people were married. That's what they said.
Really?
You know, like newlyweds, you know, a lot of them get divorced.
That's crazy.
Your first few 3 years, I think it is. I can't remember. But I was like, well, that's a, you know, that was like a half full type of analyzation of my relationship. That I was able to keep a relationship going that long, you know.
I think that people forget that, like, long-term relationships aren't always going to be the, like, honeymoon phase.
Yeah.
You know.
No.
Like, marriage, like, my friends that are married, they're like, marriage takes work. Like, it's not, like... You wake up every day like super stoked to like be next to the person all the time because you guys get fight about all sorts of stuff.
Did you live with your boyfriend?
Yeah, I did live with my boyfriend.
You did or you didn't?
I did, but I don't anymore. Don't now. Because I think because I am really young and I kind of realized like for me personally, while I thought it was financially a better decision, emotionally I wasn't mature enough for that yet. So we moved out, but we're still together.
Fine. If you guys could spend 24 hours with anyone dead or alive, who would it be, and what do you want to ask them?
Oh, well, like, okay. There are two answers to this question, only because, like, one of the, now that my mom has passed away, obviously it's my mom, but hypothetically she's still alive and I got to talk to her all the time, it'd be Gene Simmons, because I love Gene Simmons. I think he's so fascinating and a marketing genius. So I think it'd be cool just to like spend 24 hours with him and talk to him about all of his like mind workings and everything. But then, you know, obviously my mom, like, she's a very wise person, and I feel like she would have now that she is, if you want to say, like, a guardian angel, she'd have a lot of insight to, like, all the things that I'm doing, that she'd be like, if you tried this, everything would go away that was bad. And be like, that'd be cool.
It's funny that me and her, like, have, like, similar, you know, answers. Like, yes, I would definitely want to see my mom. That's, you know, and I would want to talk to her. Just talk to her. I just want to catch up. That's what I want to do. It's more about catching up, let her know what I've been doing, and you know. And as far as I'd like to meet Bruce Lee and talk to him, pick his brain. He's a very intelligent guy, and he's a guy that took the world by storm after he died. And I think that's interesting that he had that big of an effect, you know, on the world. And we were still emulating him like 30 years or whatever it is later, that, you know, after the man passed, you know, it's the biggest, one of the biggest influences on Hollywood and fighting movies and action movies. Let's see here. I hate everything agreed to a live debate I hate everything agreed to a live debate, would you do it? No, because I've already explained. And the majority of the YouTube community knows why reactions are valid and they're a good thing for YouTube. So there's no need for me to. What's it like finally meeting Tyrone Magnus? Some of these questions, I don't know what they are until I finish. You know what I mean? It's like, I don't see the whole thing. How long are you staying in Cali? I'm staying in Cali until tomorrow. I stayed 11 days. And I think she pretty much already said what it's like to meet me. Unless you want to, you know, it's not like I'm, you know, the president. let's see. Fuck it, I'm gonna say it. How big is your dick?
I wonder if any YouTubers actually disclosed, like, my penis is this big.
I'm in the house. I'm considered well endowed. How about that, some of my bitches? Now stop asking!
Ready for
Tyrone. let's see here. What superhero movie is your first favorite, second one are you most looking forward to? Superman's my favorite movie of all time, period, so.
My managers represent Kevin Costner.
Really?
Yeah.
To talk to your manager. Mm-hmm. I've been looking for a good manager and agent and everything, so yeah. Not actively looking, but in my mind, I'm like,
Yeah, it's like something that you have on your list of steps. This one's really funny.
You want to read it?
Okay, he goes, damn it, Tyrone. You know, like, 75% of the question's going to be about smashing. How many? Which way? Where? Upside down? You know you do this to yourself.
Yes.
This is funny.
He said upside down. She looks very light and pliable. Very light and pliable.
The funny thing is, I pictured, like, plywood and just, like, breaking it everywhere. Like, I don't even picture, like, anything sexual. I'm just like, plywood! I'm like a little kid. I just, like, love smashing things.
Like, if you're in the middle of it with her, you should say, like, I was wondering what was going to break first.
Just, like,
body. Your spirit! Or your body! A lot of the same questions. I haven't kept up on Flash, and I didn't know the rest of the season started. Are you finished?
Oh, I'm just stretching.
Okay.
I'm just stretching.
These are a lot of questions. I know it can kind of...
I'm good. We could probably cut it into two parts. Mm. People are very interested in the sex. Can you lift them well?
Like Sky from Tipsy Bartender. What the hell is that?
I have no idea. I'm pretty sure you could pick me up, though. I don't weigh that much.
Yeah. What are you, like, 98 pounds? You know?
No. I'm more than 100. I'm more than 100.
All right. Let's see. Have I ever thought about doing a mass reaction involving... Have I ever thought about doing a mass reaction involving major reactors? No. But we've all collabed, so, you know. Would you rather be as you are now or get $1 billion but a 50% chance of instant death?
I think I'd give him the $1 billion thing, because why not?
It's like you get the money, and then it's like you gotta wait for a second.
I take risks. Because, like, worst case scenario, I go to heaven.
Boy, man, that's like flipping a coin, man. Oh. I'll let you be the billionaire philanthropist. And you'll be able to leave all your money to people for a good cause, just in case you die.
Yeah, exactly.
In the Marvel or DC universe, would you rather be a good guy or a bad guy?
Bad guy.
Ooh.
Yeah, so.
She likes playing villains. Do you believe in ghosts and the paranormal?
Yes.
Cool. Have you had an experience?
Yes.
Holy shit. Would you mind telling the story?
I feel like it'd be long. And I debated making a video about it on my channel, actually.
Okay. Alright, well, you don't have to.
So maybe stay tuned for that video.
Yes. But I think there could be something out there. Who the hell is she? You don't know who she is? She's Noelle Coette.
There was, like, a weird moment. That was a while ago, where, like, there's a picture of my tongue, and you commented on it, and then my tongue went, like, viral for a minute. So that's how we end up knowing each other. I made fun of him on the internet with Ryan Wright.
Oh, yeah, that's what it was.
It's like a roast thing, something like Ryan was getting roasted, and I'm Dante. Like, that was when all that happened.
Yes. Where do I keep finding these fine-ass women?
The internet.
A couple of them I know, but a few of them were from Ryan.
Yep. He does have hot girls on his channel. He just finds a way.
Let's see. Are you a genius? Yes.
Yeah.
Do you have sex? Yes. That's kind of fucked up. Is she not answering? Because then it makes it look like she doesn't give her boyfriend any if she doesn't answer. But
then if I do, it looks like a whore. That's what it's like being a woman.
Because she has a boyfriend, so it's like, if she does, like, okay.
I'm
of course you do.
I know. Like, do the math, guys.
Oh, how do you avoid awkwardness with the girl who rejected you? Don't ask a girl that you see all the time. That's one way to avoid it.
Or just get over yourself. As plain as it is, don't take things personally.
Yeah, just let it go. Men by nature are the chasers, so it's kind of like, you know, it's something you just have to get used to.
Yeah, I had a huge crush on my best friend when I was like 13, and finally told him when I was 16, and he rejected me, and we're still friends, and it's fine.
Ooh.
Okay,
can you believe someone
3 years of pent up love feelings?
They rejected all that. Can you believe it?
Am I over?
Fucking psychotic! Let me tell you why.
He said I was like his friend, and that was weird.
He was gay. I was like,
No, he's got a girlfriend now. He's a nice guy. I'm so glad that did not end up happening. Like, in hindsight, I'm like, thank God I did not date him. If he ever watches this video, he's so offended.
What fictional world from a movie, book, or game would you want to live in? And black or white girls. I love both.
I really do. I don't think it's been invented yet. Like, if there was, like, a Harry Potter superhero thing.
Harry Potter?
I don't know.
Your second girl that is like so into Harry Potter, it is ridiculous.
Or I love Zelda.
Where would I want to? I'm gonna have to think about that one, man. Because every world that's cool, it's so fucking dangerous on TV. Because there's always superheroes, people that have to save you from these places. You know what I mean? It's like, wherever the utopia is. Where I don't have to worry about anything, that's where I want to go. You know.
Gilligan's Island.
Jesus.
The coconut radio, you're like, how did. Okay, so they can make a radio out of coconuts, you can't get off the island.
Retarded. Have you ever gotten into a fist fight? No.
Oh, that's the second person to ask that question.
If you don't marry Tyrone, would you then marry me?
I don't know. I have mixed feelings about marriage at the moment. I changed my mind. Like, tomorrow I'm going to get married, and then the next day I'm like, marriage. I don't know.
She's one of those stars that, like, gets married and then that's annulled a week later.
No. I I guess the thing for me is that, like, I want to be married and, like, only marry that one person.
Okay. Science. If scientists discovered a cure for cancer, would you use it since you said you don't trust scientists? Well, there's already cures for cancer, so there's that answer. Marvel already has Luke Cage, but would I redo him? Or Blade? And would I do Cyborg? Yeah, I'd probably play all three. Although, I think playing Blade or Cyborg would be more fun than Luke Cage. If you had a chance to make a movie off of any character you felt was done justice.
If it wasn't done justice yet,
what would it be?
Oh.
Mine would be Dragon Ball Z. That movie totally needs to be remade. Just like, what the fuck were they thinking? Yeah.
I have no idea. I think the problem is, like, the characters that I like, I tend to like the movies that they're in. So, like, they were done well. I don't know. I can't think of an answer to that. I'm so indecisive.
Did me and Lisa smash? No. Are you secretly Deadpool? No.
That'd be dope.
What's it like hanging with Ryan? Just want to know, is he super crazy and funny crazy jokes? He's a lot like he is on camera.
Yeah.
He is. He really is. He has his really calm moments. Like, he's not like always like dick jokes and this and hey guys. He's not always like that. But, you know, that's a pretty good impression.
Yeah. But, yeah, no, he's pretty much like he is on camera, except for, like, there are added bits of, like, more serious conversations, I guess.
Yes, yes. Yeah. He's deeper than you think.
Yeah, we tend to get some deep combos.
Have I ever asked any of these girls out? No.
You've never asked a girl?
Any girl that's been on my show, I haven't asked out, but...
Besides
the ex. Yeah. But, I was involved with one girl.
But he did not ask her out.
No, it evolved. It evolved into something. She was a subscriber that I got to know off screen. It started with a comment on her Instagram. I found her by accident, literally. And I was like, oh, that's okay. And she had friended me while I was in a relationship with Sarah. She friended me, never liked any of my pictures, she liked one picture with me and Sarah, never commented, never approached me or anything. And one day I saw her on Instagram and I said something and it just started a conversation and we started getting along and she eventually came to see me. Yeah, so, yes. But no
sex happened.
No sex happened.
No?
So. Oh, with her, yeah. She came to see me for 10 days. She cooked, she cleaned, and other things.
Whoa, this girl sounds like a dream.
Yeah, she was really good. But she, good person, I mean, yeah, she's a really good person, but distance caused many issues for us. Yes, so. Let's see, if you could choose to be any,
what is your greatest strength or weakness?
Greatest weakness is procrastination. My greatest strength is my intuition. I'm able to read people, which allows me to get along with people a lot better than a lot of people. Because you remember how she said she feels comfortable around me? I'm able to adapt to people's energy really well, I think, and understand.
Yeah, I think my greatest strength is also intuition, but my greatest weakness...
I know what your greatest weakness is.
procrastination is something I deal with, but I'm very, like, while I'm procrastinating, get very angry with myself, and I think it's more, like, the way I procrastinate, is then, like, I won't get something done, because I'm like, wait, oh, so you're just sitting there watching YouTube videos, and I kind of, like, go on to this, like, against myself thing, which is
Are you like really psycho? Bad. Would you like stupid?
I don't like hit myself in the head, but I pretty much am like that, and I'm working on it right now because I'm like I didn't realize it. Like I'm like the things that I think sometimes I'm just like, why can't you just and I'll sit there like out loud because I talk to myself out loud. My roommate is like, what are you talking to? And I'm just like you can't even figure out what to wear today.
I have got to witness that.
This happened to me. I was going to an elevator to get to my car in a parking garage, and I was like, and then this guy walked up behind me.
He was like, yep, pretty ones are always psycho.
Yeah, I'm always
don't make
myself
eye contact.
Yeah, no, when I don't realize other people are there, I talk to myself like out loud,
holy
like full
shit.
Volume, like meh, 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 meh.
Am I going to play Until Dawn or any other game soon? When I finish Bloodborne is when I will play the next game. Let's see. What made you want to react to videos? You guys requested it, so I did it.
I feel like the questions are kind of...
It's
the
weird.
Comments are kind of getting like switched.
Cause I, yeah, they're getting switched around. Flash or Arrow? Flash.
Flash. Oh, thanks for saying I'm pretty.
How I feel about the darker tone of DC, I'm fine with it for now. As long as it just doesn't get too dark. You know what I mean? Like, I don't like really sick, perverse darkness. I don't need all that. You know? How about you, Noah?
I'm a fan of things being dark.
Darkness is our ally.
Oh, yeah. We just need to start the video
about
that.
She knew she fucked up.
I know. Because when I said it, I was like, why?
If Ryan was here, he would have took advantage of that, too.
Oh, yeah. You can't say the word, like, cantaloupe, when he's like, elope. Means, you're like, anything sexual, right? Curtains.
Yeah, yep.
Curtains.
You like that? Like, do you close your curtains when you get dressed, or you like to show the world? Are you an exhibitionist? Like, he would do that, you know, just think of... But anyway, says, can you show us your tongue, Noelle, please? Woo-wee! And she flicked it.
Yeah, I did. I get comments, like, I don't really check my direct messages on Instagram that often, but like comments and then sometimes direct messages of people being like, will you please post a video of you like flicking your tongue? And I'm like,
there's like girls that only make videos doing that.
It's weird.
It's a section for porn. It's called tongue.
Really?
And all they do is show you how long their tongue is and they lick stuff. And yeah.
That's crazy.
I found it by accident.
There are some Instagram pages that like put pictures of me on there, and like I'll gain like 20 followers because there's like a picture of me like
with your tongue.
People are like, whoa.
Yep. Vivid video be calling her soon. Will I ever do challenges? Maybe. Just depends on what they are.
You should do them on my channel. I have one planned with my roommate Matthew. But I think that they're fun to do. Like that's for me. Like I like watching them. Like I'll watch YouTube videos while I'm doing it. Or something like that, but I just think they're fun.
Okay.
It's like, why not do it?
We can do that. Do you have any exciting projects to announce? I could let you know that a show wants me to be permanent guest on their show. Awesome. They're pretty big, and yeah, I mean, yes. So, how's life? Great.
Yeah. That's pretty good.
Was your Honda totaled after the accident? No. You need to chill. I don't need to chill nothing. I have as many guests on my show as I want. Don't be mad because I got pretty women on the show. The hell is wrong with you? Do I like heavy metal music?
I went through a huge heavy metal phase when I was younger.
Headbanging and shit.
I was just by myself. I was that weird kid that would like write poetry while like blasting heavy metal music.
yeah, I like heavy metal. But I don't like all the, like, death metal and Satan metal and all that other metal. Am I going to get a girl? Is that what you're laughing at?
Yes. It's just like Tyrone, why not? This was so funny.
I am in a transitional phase of my life. And right now, I am taking applications for the position. It'll happen sooner or later. Why do I suck so bad at games? Sorry, I don't, because I've beaten every game that I've played so far. So you can eat a dick! Let's see here. Would you rather die from a gun to the head or die from being stabbed 19 times? Gun to the head.
Gun.
Because you don't feel that. Okay, that's stupid.
What is my favorite what? Just what is your favorite?
One Piece, what's that?
I don't know what
you
that is.
You ever heard of One Piece?
No.
I haven't heard of One Piece. To Noelle, what were your first thoughts when you met me? That's a little different from...
Yeah.
My first thoughts were her was just like, oh, look how small she is.
That's exactly what I was like, not expecting you, like size-wise, like when you're used to seeing somebody on your phone, because I mostly watch YouTube videos on my phone, it was kind of weird to like see you in person and like you actually like stand up, because I think you're sitting down when I came in, and it's like funny, like Tyrone is like this big in my world, and so to see him in real life, it's more of like,
you see what she did? That was, I'm sorry, I have to point that out. She goes, Tyrone's like this big in my world. you keep stepping into those holes. That's pretty good, Kurt. I like that.
Make a meme of that.
Oh yeah.
I suck.
Dude, that now I'm gonna leave it alone.
I'm just gonna start making a square and be like, get that time. Yeah.
Yes, he's that big in your world. So I was bigger than you expected or smaller or?
I think you're shorter than I expected.
Everyone thinks I'm like 6'3".
Yeah, literally. I thought you were gonna be like, but you know, whatever. I'm also like really, I guess you're not short, but it's like I'm short, so.
How tall are you?
5'2".
Okay. How's the weather? Psychotic. Like, it doesn't know what it wants to be.
It's been crazy.
Bipolar.
It's been pretty crazy. It's freezing at night, but then it's warm, like hot during the day. And it's raining.
White booty or black booty, which one tastes better? They taste the same to me. Have you ever shit your pants? If so, how? As a child? I'm sure I have, and I don't remember. tips and fitness advice would be great. My question is for Noelle. Why did you stop making videos on YouTube?
That's something that it's not that I stopped. It's that my internet was so bad, and it wouldn't upload anything. So now I've got friends with better internet that I'm, like, trying to work out bumming their internet, basically, because, like, my internet doesn't work. I had, like, 3 or 4 different videos that I tried to upload that wouldn't upload because my plan was to do one video a week, and I just ended up getting a little discouraged, plus like holidays and all that random stuff is just lots of stuff going on, but you know, working on it.
Broncos or Panthers?
Broncos.
I don't know. When am I coming to Barbados? Never thought about it, but hey, I'd like to visit. Did you like Creed?
I actually haven't seen it yet.
Okay, I did. I liked it. Is psychology a fun class to major in? I loved psychology class. And then I took sociology also. I loved both of them. Loved both of them. I actually might go back to school just to get a degree in it. Like, I just like understanding the mind so much. Are you going to Comic-Con?
I'm not. It's really expensive.
Really?
Yeah.
Like how much?
You know? I'll tell you, it's a long story. I have a friend that gets, like, whatever the passes are when you're, like, actually involved in Comic-Con. But okay. It's the room. So if you don't know somebody to stay with, it's about, like, $1,000 a night at a hotel room. And all of the hotels are booked up right now.
What?
Yeah, I'll talk to you more about this later. Because I find ways to get shit done. And I found a couple hotel rooms. But, yeah, they were, like, $5,000.
Comic-Con, you're crazy. Yeah. As far as I'm concerned, you can kiss my.
You can Airbnb it, though. If any of you guys are trying to go to Comic-Con, look into Airbnbs, but do it now. Because right now, all of the hotels are already booked, and they were booked like a week ago.
Oh, look at this. So, this one's written with
Madame
taste.
Madame Coette.
So it says, question for Madame Coette. What made you want to make a makeup style tutorial? YouTube. Let's just say YouTube. And
yeah.
Who is your... Oh, I see. I see what they were saying. Who's your favorite current makeup artist on YouTube?
I started... My mom actually never wore makeup. And so how I learned to do makeup was on YouTube. And I was also homeschooled and really bad at math. So I'd watch math videos on YouTube, like how to do long division and how to put on eyeliner. And that's kind of what started me on like making my own videos as far as that goes. And then now I don't necessarily watch makeup people on YouTube. I guess I really like Annie Jeffrey's makeup tutorials. Like she does like really like clean makeup. Or there's this girl named Roxaurus that does like really, really awesome Halloween, like more like avant-garde type stuff. But yeah, I just think it's a lot of fun.
Okay. If you could interview any superhero, who would it be?
Oh, I don't know. That's so hard.
I would interview Batman. Because like, he seems very... He's such a deep, distraught...
That's why he's my favorite.
Yeah, I want to know about, you know, Clark. While he's my favorite, he's more... He's all around good guy. He's had a good upbringing, you know. But Batman is so damn deep that
probably Iron Man.
See what makes him tick. Oh, that would be fun.
Yeah,
that would be fun talking to Tony.
He's also like a successful human and like a superhero.
Yeah.
Again, like I just like talking to people who are successful because you learn from them.
Yeah, I would like to talk to Tony. I might change that because Bruce inherited his while he still runs it. Like Tony's like, well, I'm wondering if Tony, but his dad was first though. Well, so they're both similar. But anyway, also ever spit a dope 16? I've never tried my hand at rap. No, how about you, Noelle? I can't believe that she has.
I'm not good at rapping, but I made a video for a friend of mine who's in the hospital when I was like 15, and I wrote a rap song for her and a bunch of our friends that don't have any sort of rhythm got together and made this video for her to like cheer her up while she was in the hospital. But it's pretty bad though.
Have you ever gotten caught cheating?
I just pictured like a weird scenario where like I actually like physically got caught cheating, and that was just so awkward and uncomfortable. But no, like that'd be like the worst feeling in the world.
It would be. Shout out to Mons Solis. Coffee or tea?
Depends on my mood.
Coffee. If I'm going to go for taste, I'm going for coffee. 2 tablespoons of sugar cane juice. And if I'm going for just health, period, I'm going to have to pick tea.
Yeah, like tea's a bit better for you. I'm trying to swap.
Tea's better, exactly.
I do drink tea more often than coffee.
What do I have for advice for someone going to the gym?
Go.
Go for your goal. Go! Go! Yes. Good. Be consistent. Consistency. There we go. That is it. Consistency. And work hard. If you were featured in a video game, what would be the plot of the game?
I would want it to be like the Zelda video games, but that like Link gets trapped and then I get to be Zelda and like save him. Be like, yeah.
Have you ever played The Last of Us?
Mm-mm.
Incredible video game. I mean, I clapped when I was done playing the game. That's how good it was. You have no idea until you play it. You have no idea. You get to take on the role of a guy, and then later on you get to take on the role of this girl that he meets. It's like literally playing a movie.
Yeah.
It is so good. I would like to be in a zombie apocalypse type thing. Yeah. When I get weapons and stuff, you get to use me to do stuff like that. That'd be fun. That's what it was kind of about. How did we meet? On YouTube, I commented, I think, and she might have said something back, and that's kind of how it was.
Yeah.
What's your middle name?
Renee.
Ah, it's Renee. Mine is Maurice. You know what your middle name means?
Mm-mm.
My name's Moore, which means dark skinned. Yes. You thought it meant like more.
No, yes, more. Yeah, that's what. I mean, you meant to go to dirty. I was like, Oh, I thought it said PJs. I was like, what?
Does Noelle like you? She already said, we already answered that question by each other. And how long is your tongue, Noelle? Please answer. Have you measured it?
I've never thought of measuring my tongue before.
I wish I had a ruler, because I'd break it out right now.
It's really not that long. I don't get it. I don't know. I also don't think I have big lips or big eyes. So some people are like, you're crazy. But I don't really think I have that big of a tongue.
You know what's funny? They look bigger on screen now that I'm looking at her than... It's, you know what it could be also? There's proportion, you know? So maybe her tongue looks big in proportion to her face. Wait, stick your tongue out. It looks bigger on screen than...
I'm
not really let down. I'm not really let down, you know what I mean? But, I don't know. I think it's the way her face is shaped.
Yeah, I feel like
your lips are held on her
face. I get told though in person that I have huge eyes and huge lips. So maybe it's just because like we're sitting right next to each other and you've gotten used to my face. And you're like, that's just Noelle's face. It's not big. Like, that's just what it looks like.
That could be it.
I don't know.
She has a traditionally, by the way, I studied this. She has a traditionally pretty face for a woman that men are attracted to. She has a round face.
Wait, that's so straight.
With a small point to the chin. And she does have bigger eyes. They're not really big, but they're a nice size. They're not like anime big, but, you know, yeah. So this is actually the traditional face that most men are attracted to. So, yeah, just wanted to put that in there.
Oh, great.
So, you're that numbers-wise, you do better dating than other women.
Oh, but I already got boyfriends, so...
Well, yeah, I'm saying if you didn't have a boyfriend, you know what I mean.
Oh, yeah.
Barry Allen or Wally West?
I don't know what that means.
Okay. Barry Allen is like the Flash, and so is Wally. Yes, they're both the Flash, but they're different.
Oh,
Flashes, yeah. Do you watch anime?
Mm-mm.
Okay. Let's see here. We'll probably wrap this up. Does Noelle and Tyrone mind if fans stop her for a moment of your time? I guess if you're asking, do we mind if someone stops us?
Like in person, if they're like, oh, hey.
I don't care.
No, that doesn't bother me. It's only happened to me like twice, but it's always like made my day because I'm like, oh, that's cool. So, plus it's kind of nice to like see people that have either like watched my movies or things like that. And it happens like on social media, like people will comment and be like, I just saw blah 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 and you're great in it, or like, have you ever thought about playing this kind of character? And like, I think it's cool hearing from people that have watched my movies or YouTube and stuff, and it's kind of nice to put a face to the people that are watching things, and it's because of you guys that I get jobs. So
Do you ever feel pressured that 600,000 are waiting for your videos? Sometimes, yeah, I do. There's a pressure. Sometimes it's like, yeah, you know, I got to put up some videos today. But sometimes I'll be busy with other things, or I just might want to kind of relax for the day. But I know you guys are waiting for something. So, kind of like, you know, got to keep the fans happy. When you're eating barbecue, what's your favorite cut? Brisket. This person's into meat. Brisket, ribs, pulled pork, or sausage?
I really like pulled pork sandwiches. Those are so good. But then brisket just has like a... There's actually this, like, Mexican place in Dallas that does, like, brisket tacos that are, like... Mm-hmm. I'm not an if person or an or person. I'm an and person.
And. Ribs. Period, point blank. And pulled pork or nothing but a damn version of that, so. You have a dog?
I don't. I've had dogs in the past, but I have no pets at the moment. Okay. Where did my chapstick go?
Okay, so I guess we can finish here.
Will you ever cosplay?
Probably not, just because it's so much damn work to make one of those costumes. I'd rather buy one and just walk in somewhere, you know. How about you?
I have mad respect for people who do it, though. Like, I've seen some amazing cosplay stuff, but I just don't have the patience. I'm a very impatient person.
What's kind of funny is, what are your first impressions of each other? Which is similar to a lot of the other questions. But one thing I noticed about her, she takes a little time to warm up to you.
Would you say that?
And I said that when I got after you left. I said, you know, I said she's a little bit more skittish than
you think. Yeah.
Yeah. And Jerry, you know, from Ryan's show, he was like, yeah, she's got like the nervous little dog type energy sometimes. Mm. And I was like, yeah, because she like kind of curled up in the corner and talked to us.
Yeah, when I first meet people, I was like,
yeah, that's exactly what she was doing. So she was sitting
like
on this side of me. Yeah, you ever see them little chihuahuas, they're all like curled up sitting next to you, and they're just feeling you out, looking at you, and their tails wagging or something. That's the kind of energy she had.
Yeah, I'm very, I like to observe and assess a situation.
Yes. All right, y'all, so that was it. Did you have fun?
Yeah, cool. Class. Thanks for the question.
Yeah, so maybe we'll do another video. I don't know. This one tired me out, but I can think of a, I can probably find a reaction for us to do. Is there any information you'd like to leave them with, like your Instagram or Twitter or YouTube?
Sure, I guess. YouTube is Noe Knows Not, Instagram is also Noe Knows Not, and then Facebook and Twitter are Noelle Coet, N-O-E-L-L-C-O-E-T. But yeah, I guess thanks for watching and tuning in and all that fun stuff, and
we'll see you later.
Yeah.
1 million subscribers.